Hi everyone, welcome to Hatha Yoga. My name is Michelle Chua. So we're going to begin in child's pose. Please bring your inner edges of your feet to touch. You can have your knees together or as wide apart as you need so that you can most comfortably allow your pelvis to sink down to your feet. If your knees are sensitive to bending this much, you place a folded blanket behind the backs of your knees. You could also straddle or hug, bear hug a pillow if that's more comfortable for you. But I do invite you to encourage length throughout your back, throughout your spine by reaching your arms forward here. You either rest your forehead on the floor or on top of a prop. Allow your shoulders to soften back, creating more length through the sides of your neck. Any shifting you might need to do, like gently massaging your forehead on the ground by slowly shaking your head no, also giving your neck a little loosening. Maybe reaching your right hand further forward and just feel a little more lengthening through the right side of your torso as you draw your right sitting bone back. And then whatever you do to one side, balance it out on the other side. Here's a quote by Sri K. Patabis Joyce about pranayama. Through the practice of pranayama, the mind becomes arrested in a single direction. So throughout this week, we've been highlighting this fourth limb of the Eightfold Path of Yoga. Why would we want to cultivate a mind capable of one-pointed attention? And how does that benefit us spiritually? It has been my experience that where my attention is, there I am. If I'm listening to you with my undivided attention, I am with you. If my mind wanders, I'm not there either. My ability to show up for anything is predicated upon my ability to get my mind to cooperate. If we want to love anything, communicate anything, accomplish anything, we must have a mind that will go along with a plan. It is this very ability that pranayama practice is cultivating. So we now shift towards the inner layers of self in our practice, more focus on the inner self as we transition from the previous limb, asana, physical postures, though we're still practicing that, but highlighting the breath, and then we'll move on to the mind stuff in the later limbs. So how is your breath as you're here in child's pose now? What is the quality of your breathing? Bring your mind's eye to your back body from your lower back, mid-back, upper back and neck, even the back of your skull, backs of your legs. And can you imagine your next inhalation deepening into your back body? As you're extending your arms forward, maybe even further reach the fingertips ahead, further draw the sitting bones back, increasing that length and space in your back body. And as you open the mouth to exhale, let any sound release. Each inhale, increasing length in your back body. Crown of your head reaching forward. Tailbone lengthening back. And then again through your mouth, sound the exhale. One more deep breath like that, a little fuller, a little deeper, a little slower. Maybe even catch some hang time at the top of your inhalation for a few seconds. Really drawing the breath out with some kind of sound. I'm feeling the vibration of that sound. As you empty the breath, maybe linger at the bottom a few seconds too. And then see if you can continue breathing with your mouth closed. Inhaling, exhaling evenly and sustained through your nose. Let's try by counting to five as you breathe in and to five as you breathe out in the effort of balancing the breath. So empty this one out. Then slowly inhale for five, four, three, two, one. Exhale through the nose, five, four, three, two, one. Inhale through the nose, five, four, three, two, one. Exhale, five, four, three, two, one, perhaps a little longer on your count. Now adding a gentle whisper by softly narrowing the back of your throat. We call this Ujjayi Pranayama, which means victorious breathing. And as you listen to that very subtle whisper, not forceful, very gentle, let the next inhalation take you forward onto hands and knees, where you parallel your shins, knees under hips, wrists under shoulders, and continue into cow pose, coiling your chest up, drawing your shoulders back and down. Then with the exhalation, slowly rounding into cat pose by contracting your belly, dropping your skull, and tucking your tailbone beneath. On your own, taking about four more cycles of cat-cow, synchronize to your breath. Bringing into the qualities of both your breathing and your moving, the same qualities within your intent for your yoga practice. Setting your intention or sankalpa in motion. Finish this last round of Bidalasana. And then tucking your toes, spread your fingers really wide. Think of a tiger paw. So as you press through the tips of your fingers as though they're suction cups, there's a slight lift of energy through the center of your palms. And then tucking your toes, lift your hips high. And then allow a few breaths of shifting around in your first downward facing dot. You may like to pedal your feet in place, perhaps adding the swiveling of your hips left and right, inviting space into your side body, side waist, outer hips. Maybe even shaking your head gently. You're shaking your head no several times. Nodding your head yes several times, and even opening the mouth and loosening your jaw of any tension. Still breathing through your nose. Listen to that whispering sound. Feel the base of your thumbs, the base of your index fingers rooting into the earth. So there's a slight inward spiraling of your forearms towards the ground, contrasted by a slight outward spiraling or external rotation of your upper arms towards the ground. So you broaden your shoulder blades apart by spinning your triceps towards the earth. And then feel free to bend your knees any amount. Go as generously bent as needed. So you can draw your tailbone as high as you can and as far back as you can, recreating or even lengthening further your back body. Sinking your heels towards the earth. It's okay if they don't touch the floor. Firm your belly inward towards your spine while pressing your chest backward towards your shins. And then now let's hold still. Let this body, this mind-body vessel of yours, be a spacious container for life force to flow through deep breaths. Two more breaths in Adho Mukha Svanasana. And then start to step your feet one foot forward, so it's shorter stance of downward dog, but separate your feet even wider apart sideways, maybe as wide as the outer edges of your mat. As you keep your left hand on the ground or propped up on a block, cross your right hand to catch hold of your outer left ankle or calf. Root your right heel into the earth and draw your right sitting bone behind you as you spiral your chest to look underneath your left armpit towards the sky. Let your head be heavy, float your shoulders up away from it, and then keep twisting here as you try to level out your hips for just another three deep breaths. Can you feel lengthening down the left side of your torso? Can you feel the rotation of your rib cage, especially underneath your lowest ribs at your waistline? On your next exhalation, lower your right hand in front on the floor or on a block, then cross your left hand to catch hold of your outer right calf or ankle. Rooting your left heel into the earth, draw your left sitting bone towards your rear wall. Spiral your chest towards your right wall as you look underneath your right armpit towards the sky. Then completely relax your neck and jaw. Lift your shoulders away from them. Deep breaths. On your next exhalation, walk your hands back towards your feet. And let's make our way into your version of Malasana, a squat. So turning out your legs from your hip sockets. Allow your knees and middle toes to turn out the same degree as you bend your knees apart. Now you could grab your blocks or blankets to sit on like a stool. You could sit all the way on the ground. Or if it feels pretty natural for your body to hover your pelvis, you could keep it that way. Let your arms help splay your inner thighs apart, whether you join your hands in prayer or rest your hands on the floor or on props. We're gonna be here for a few breaths. As I explain the next breathing techniques we're gonna dive into and which will be a part of our meditation practice at the end. They are the bandhas, and bandha means lock. And the bandhas of pranayama are methods of holding the breath and locking it in to certain parts of the body. There are three basic bandhas: the chin lock, the abdominal lock, and the anal lock, that work on retention of the breath in the three major areas of the body. And this is from Wheels of Life, a book about the seven chakras. So the chin lock, we're gonna start there in a moment. Jalandhara bandha sends energy into the head and stimulates the thyroid gland and throat chakra. Simply inhale fully, contract the throat, and lower your chin towards your chest, keeping the back straight. Hold the breath as long as comfortable, but don't push it, for it can make you feel quite faint if done improperly. So find a comfortable seat as you begin with that one. You may like to sit on a prop, like a blanket. Again, find a way that you can allow your spine to feel really tall without being rigid, so your shoulders are relaxed. You can rest your hands in your lap. So again, the chin lock. We inhale fully, contract the throat, so we're holding the inhale, and lowering the head down to the chest, so you're squeezing the thyroid, but keeping your back straight. And then you hold the breath for as long as it's comfortable for you. Of course, avoiding feeling faint. You don't want to push your chin to your chest too hard. And then you exhale and release. So let's try that three rounds. So those of you who might be pregnant, skip any of the bandhas for now, and you can continue with ujjayi breath or breathing into your belly or another breathing technique that you prefer. So Jalandhara bandha. Here we go. Let's take a deep breath to clear out before we start. Inhale through the nose. Exhale to your mouth. And now to begin, inhale to your nose. Hold your breath in, spine is tall, tuck your chin to your chest, contract your throat. Hold the breath there for as long as is comfortable. And when you're ready, exhale, relax and let it go. Two more rounds of chin lock. Inhale deeply. Hold the breath in, contract your throat. Draw chin to chest, back is long. And when you're ready, exhale, relax, let it go. Last one of Jalandhara Bandha. Inhale deeply. Hold the breath in, contract your throat, chin to chest, back is long. And at your own pace, relax. Come back to Ujjayi breath for a few rounds. So the next lock or bandha is Mula Bandha. And if you'll remember, Mula means root, and it's related to the root energy center at the base of the spine. It's also called the anal lock. It tones the root chakra. And it's practiced by tightening the perineum and anal sphincter after inhalation while the breath is held. And this stimulates sleeping kundalini, it says, or the energy force to awaken energy in all of the energy centers. So we inhale deeply, we hold the breath, and as you hold the breath to your degree, you engage, you think of contracting your pelvic floor, the anal sphincter, the perineum, you just keep it contract as you're holding the breath in. And then when you can't hold it anymore, you relax everything. Exhale. So let's try that three rounds. Inhale deeply. Hold the breath. Contract at the base of your spine, your pelvic floor. Keep the spine tall, shoulders relaxed. Hold it to your own degree. And then when you're ready, let it go, relax. Two more times. Inhale deeply. Hold the breath in. Think of lifting your pelvic floor, contracting the perineum, anal sphincter. And when you're ready, exhale, release. Last time. Inhale deeply. Hold the breath. Lift your pelvic floor, contract at the base. And when you're ready, exhale, relax. All right, let's come on up to stand for the last one, Uddiyana Bandha. And this is something I practice every morning right when I get up. So it's best to do on an empty stomach. It helps to massage your digestive organs. And it's best to do standing up. We'll take a deep breath in through the nose. Exhale it all out through the mouth. Holding the breath out, you'll draw in your belly and lift it towards your rib cage. Like you're bringing the organs into the rib cage, holding the breath until you can't anymore. And then you'll inhale, relax. So let's try three rounds of Uddiyana Bandha, abdominal lock. Take a deep breath in. Exhale deeply. Hold the breath. Lift lower belly in and up. Try not to inhale here. You're holding the breath out for as long as you can. And then inhale to relax, soften the belly. Round two when you're ready. Inhale through the nose. Exhale through the mouth. Hold the breath out. Contract the belly, lift it. Lower belly in and up. Holding the breath out. And when you're ready, let it go. Inhale, soften. Last round. Inhale deeply. Exhale, let it go. Hold your breath out. Draw lower belly in and lift it up towards the rib cage. And And inhale to relax. Come on up to the top of your mat. Hopefully that's warmed you up a bit already. Inhale, sweep your arms overhead. Watch your palms touch. Exhale, bow forward, sun salutation A. Inhale, lengthen halfway, breathing through the nose. Step into plank, knees down or legs straight. Belly stays lifted as you glide forward, exhaling through Chaturanga Dandasana. Let's come all the way down on the first one. Hug your elbows close to your sides, point your toes. Inhale, coil your chest up into Bhujangasana, Cobra Pose. Exhale, tuck your toes, draw the navel in to press up through plank, lifting your hips, downward facing dog, three breaths. Inhale. Exhale, three. Inhale. Exhale, two. Inhale, bend your knees, lift your heels and hips. Look forward, exhale first. Hold the breath out. Think of contracting the anal sphincter, Mula Bandha, as you walk or float to the top of your mat. Inhale, lengthen halfway. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, sweep your arms to rise. Palms touch. Exhale, mountain pose. Two more rounds. Inhale, sweep your arms up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, lengthen forward. This time, step to plank or float right into Chaturanga Dandasana. Into Cobra or Upward Dog as you breathe in. Lengthen your legs, point your toes. Contract your belly to lift your hips as you exhale to Downward Dog. Three breaths. Inhale deeply. Exhale, three. Inhale. Exhale, two. Inhale, bend your knees, look forward, lift your hips high. Exhale, hold the breath out, engage Uddiyana Bandha, the belly lock and the root lock, as you walk or float to the top. Inhale, lengthen halfway. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, rise, palms touch, look up. Exhale, back to mountain pose. Last round, inhale, sweep your arms. Urdhva Hastasana, exhale, fold, Uttanasana. Inhale, Ardha Uttanasana. Now engage Mula Bandha, Uddiyana Bandha, belly and root. As you float, step back. Take it all the way through Cobra or Upward Facing Dog. And exhale into Downward Facing Dog. Again, three breaths, inhale. Exhale, three. Inhale. Exhale, two. Inhale, bend your knees, lift your heels and hips. Think of the belly lock and the root lock. Empty breath, walk or float to the top. Inhale, lengthen halfway. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, rise all the way up, palms touch. Exhale, hands together at your heart, preparing to balance here in Vrikshasana, tree pose. Shift your weight onto your left foot, spread your toes, feel a lift of the arches of your left foot. Rotate your right thigh to turn out like you did in the squat, so the sitting bone reaches towards your inner left heel. And then place the sole of your right foot against your inner left ankle, calf, or thigh, really pressing the leg and the sole against each other. And then can you engage Mula Bandha here? Keeping the breath at Ujjayi, inhale through the nose and exhale through the nose. Can you engage the lower belly in and up here, Uddiyana Bandha? Maybe you raise your arms overhead. Let's take another three deep breaths in tree pose. And then joining your hands at your heart, set your right foot down, back to mountain pose. Right away, shift your weight onto your right foot. lifting the arches of your right foot as you spread your toes. Turn out your left thigh at the hip, wrapping the sitting bone down towards your inner right heel. Press the sole of your left foot against your inner right ankle, calf, or thigh, and really press into your midline with right leg and left sole. Can you feel a lift of your pelvic floor, a drawing in of your lower belly and up, standing tall with your shoulders relaxed? Anywhere you want to place your arms, last three breaths in Vrikshasana. And as you're ready, join your hands at your heart and step your left foot to touch your right foot, moving right into Sun Salutation B. One breath, one movement. Let your knees come together as you inhale into chair, perhaps graze your fingers against the ground, sitting that low as the arms rise. Exhale, hinge forward to fold. Inhale, lengthen halfway. Engage Mula Bandha, Uddiyana Bandha, as you walk or float back to lower through Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhaling into Cobra or Urdhva Mukha Svanasana, Upward Facing Dog. Exhale to Downward Facing Dog. Inhale, raise your right leg from the inseam of the leg, keeping your hips squared. Exhale, round forward through plank, lowering your right foot softly inside of right hand. Spin the back heel down, feet are hips distance. Inhale, rise and face forward, arms overhead, warrior one. With your exhale, lower through Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhale into Cobra or Upward Facing Dog. Exhale into Downward Facing Dog. Then inhale, raise your left leg from the inseam. Exhale, round through plank to gently land the foot inside of your left hand. Spin the back heel down, feet are hips distance, facing forward. Inhale, rise. Virabhadrasana one. Exhale, riding your breath down through Chaturanga Dandasana. Then inhale to lift your chest, Cobra or Upward Dog. Exhale to lift your hips as you contract the belly. 3 to 5 breaths in Adho Mukha Svanasana. Feel the balance in taking in and letting go through each breath. And you feel openness in your shoulders and neck. Openness through all of your back body, even down the backs of your legs. Preparing to walk or float forward, bend your knees, look past where you want to land your feet. And once you've emptied the breath, engaging Mula Bandha at the base of the spine, engaging Uddiyana Bandha with breath held out, walk or float to the top of your mat. That's what gives the spring to catch the airtime. Inhale, lengthen halfway. Exhale, forward fold, knees touching. Inhale, sit back into chair pose, Utkatasana. We're gonna add a moving twist, so keep your knees in one line, keep sitting in chair, and then backstroke your right arm, twisting by turning your chest to face your right wall, arms wide open like a T, open across the collarbones. Inhale, sweep your right arm down and forward, both arms forward and up in chair. Exhale, backstroke the left arm, rotate your rib cage, but keep your hips still facing forward. Inhale, reach the left arm down and forward. Exhale, bow forward. Inhale, lengthen halfway. Step or float into your vinyasa. Take it all the way through. We'll meet in Downward Facing Dog. Downward Facing Dog. As you keep your two hips leveled, inhale, raise your right leg behind you. Keeping your shoulders leveled, exhale, cross your right knee to tap your left elbow in a twist, coming forward to plank. Inhale, raise your right leg behind you. Same thing, twice more. Exhale, cross the right knee to tap left tricep. Keep your shoulders leveled over your wrists. Inhale, right leg back. Last time, cross the knee to left tricep. Set your right foot inside of right hand. Lower your back knee, legs hips width apart, front knee right over the heel, and then root down to your legs to rise in a kneeling lunge, Anjaneyasana. So here, feel that your two hip bones are evenly facing forward. You're slightly drawing your right hip back and rotating your left outer hip forward, as well as lifting your frontal hip bones, lengthening your tailbone down, lifting your back ribs. And then as your arms are raised, relaxing your shoulders. Take hold of your left wrist with your right hand and take a deep breath as you lift your spine a little taller. Keep your legs still, rooted. Exhale, begin to side bend to your right. Right where you are in your range, inhale, pause and lengthen through the center of your spine. Exhale, continue to side bend, just doing that a couple more breaths. Feel that your front ribs are hugging in towards your back body and your shoulder blades are releasing down onto your back ribs. Next inhale, come back to center, backstroke your right arm towards your rear wall, reach your left arm towards your front wall, and now really keep your legs still here. Not rotating the pelvis, but isolate the rotation right under your rib cage at your waist in an upright twist. So you're purely using your obliques here to generate that twist. You can get a little taller, like a string is lifting through the top of your head toward your ceiling, with the shoulders both softened down as you continue to rotate your rib cage. Now taking your left elbow with your right hand, hook your left elbow outside of your right thigh. Make sure that you see your right heel directly under your right knee. It's not forward of the knee. And then use your right fist to gently press into your left palm. Pause here, take a deep breath, and stretch your spine to trace the midline of your mat, sliding your shoulder blades both down your back. And as you exhale, can you apply Uddiyana Bandha, the belly drawing in and up while rotating your rib cage even further into your twist. Now, as we take four more breaths, option to tuck your left toes, keep your hips squared, and straighten your left leg, knee off the floor. Notice the quality of your breath here in this final twist. One more deep breath. Look down at your right foot. Place your two hands to frame it, perhaps placing a block on the inside of your right foot, and then step your left foot 1 foot forward, spinning the heel down. Your feet still hips width apart so that your hips are evenly facing forward, but now straighten your legs. Engage the front muscles of your thighs. Bring your hands to your hips. You may need a strap here as we're about to open the shoulders. Firm your belly in, then inhale, rise up to stand. So the strap, if you're using it, hold it in your left hand, let it dangle behind your back, and then raise your left arm. With the help of your right hand, rotate your left outer upper arm forward. Bend your left elbow behind your head, pressing both shoulder blades down. Let your left hand land between your shoulder blades. Reach your right hand underneath, grab the other end of the strap. You could be holding your shirt if you don't have a strap. And then walk your hands as close together as you can. You might be able to clasp your fingers and release the strap. Now feel how rooted your legs are. They're energized, they're stable, your hips are squared. Take a deep breath and coil your chest up. Feel your throat open. And as you exhale, begin to hinge forward, maybe 1/3 of your range, while firming your belly in towards your back. Pause as you breathe in, re-engage the muscles of your legs, and lengthen your spine further forward. Hinge a little more as you breathe out. Now let's take another three breaths, exploring your range in pyramid pose or Parsvottanasana. Feel the weight of your back outer heel really rooted, offering counterbalancing support. And keep both legs solid, belly firming in without locking the knees. Inhale, lift your spine parallel to the floor. Adding another twist, lower your left hand either on the left side of your front foot, right under your shoulder, or on the right side of your front foot on a block of the floor. You might use your right thumb here to hook your right outer hip crease slightly back to re-level your two hips, grounding through toe spread. Breathe in again to lengthen your spine forward. Feel the rotation of your rib cage like a globe spinning on the axis of your spine, twisting to face the right wall. Raise your right arm. Breathe in as you lengthen your spine, firm your outer hips towards your midline, and generate that twist mostly from your obliques, sides of your waist. Three more breaths in revolved triangle pose or Paritta Trikonasana. Notice the quality of your breathing here. On your next exhale, looking at your right foot, set your two hands down to frame it, then step back for a vinyasa or cat, cow, or nun. We'll meet in downward facing dog. You choose what comes here. Arriving in Adho Mukha Svanasana for two deep breaths, reestablishing space and focus. Then keeping your hips leveled, inhale, raise your left leg back. Keeping your shoulders leveled, exhale, cross the left knee to tap your right elbow, come forward to plank. Twice more, inhale, raise your left leg back. Twisting at your waist, exhale, cross the knee to right tricep, shoulders over wrists. Inhale, left leg back. Exhale, cross the knee to right tricep, look forward, balancing your shoulders. Step your left foot just inside of your left hand and lower your right knee. Feet hips width apart, front knee right over the heel, root down to your legs and rise up. Kneeling lunge, Anjaneyasana. So feel a sense of your right outer hip rotating forward and your left outer hip drawing back. Your frontal hip bones slightly lifting and your tailbone descending while your back ribs slightly lift. And as you're raising your arms, shoulders soft, neck long, with your left hand, catch hold of your right wrist and lift your crown, your spine a little taller. Take a deep breath. Exhale, begin to side bend to your left. Legs are solid here. Inhale, pause to re-lengthen through the center of your spine. Then exhale, side bend some more if you can. A few more breaths. Notice here that you're hugging in your front ribs rather than sticking them out forward into a back bend. And that your shoulders are giving your neck space. Rooted through both legs, inhale back to center with your spine. The right elbow with your left hand, lean your spine forward and then rotate. I almost forgot something, let's come back up. Reach your right arm forward, spine is vertical. Backstroke your left arm towards your rear wall. Can't forget this part. And then twist. Upright, no leverage. Grow through the center of your spine, melt your two shoulder blades down, expand to your arms and continue to twist. Can you feel the power of Manipura at the solar plexus That is your solar plexus energy center, that which stokes digestive fire and the fire to have willpower to take action, to make conscious change when needed in your life. All right, so continue to use your obliques and take your right elbow this time and hook it to the outside of your left thigh with a fist of your left hand pressing into your right palm. Stabilize to your legs and inhale, trace your spine down the center line of your mat. Shoulder blades down your back. Exhale, hollow your belly. You could apply a little Uddiyana Bandha while you rotate your chest to face your left wall even more. Breath by breath. Option to add straightening your right leg if you did so on the first side, tucking your right toes, lifting the knee, and keeping your hips leveled while you twist. Four more breaths. Looking down at your left foot, lower your hands to frame it. You may want to put a block on the right side of that foot. Step your right foot forward, one foot. Spin the heel down. Keep your feet hips width apart, legs straight now. Entire soles of your feet on the earth. Engage the front muscles of your thighs. Then bring your hands to your hips and firming your belly, inhale, slowly rise up. Now you may want to use a strap for your right shoulder here. Take it in your right hand if so, raise your right arm, and let your left hand help rotate your right outer upper arm forward. Bring the elbow behind your skull, landing your right hand between your shoulder blades. Draw your shoulders down and reach your left hand behind you underneath to grab the other end of your strap or your shirt. Walk your hands as close together as you can, perhaps your fingers clasp. And then reground your feet. Spread your toes, lift the arches of your feet, engage the front muscles of your thighs. Engage your belly. Inhale, coil your chest up. Exhale, with a long, long back body, begin to hinge forward. Pause as you inhale. Lengthen crown of your head, sternum towards front wall. Then hinge forward a little more if you can as you breathe out. Sending left outer hip back. Rotating right outer hip forward. About three more breaths in Parsvottanasana. Now feel how stable your legs are, belly center is. Then inhale, lift your spine parallel to the floor. Lower your right hand either on the right side of your right foot, maybe on a block right under your shoulder, or on the left side of your right foot. You might use your left thumb to help tack your left outer hip slightly back, re-leveling your hip squared. Ground to your feet and inhale, lengthen your spine forward, shoulders down your back. Exhale again, use your obliques, rotate your rib cage, your chest to face your left wall. Raising your left arm, continue to twist, breath by breath. Paritta Trikonasana. Revolved Triangle Pose. Perhaps you're looking up towards your left thumb if your balance feels pretty solid. Two more breaths. Then looking down at your left foot, step into plank, optional vinyasa or few cat cows or child's pose. Let's meet again in downward facing dog. Lion's breath. Deeply inhale, fill up your belly, your chest, your back body. Open your eyes and mouth wide, stick out your tongue, breathe out. Ha! Cooling, cleansing breath. One more time, inhale deeply, drink it in all the way to the top. You might like to cross your eyes as you open your mouth too. Exhale, tongue out. Walk your hands back to meet your feet, folding over your legs. Hatha-hastasana as we stretch the outer wrists. Slip your palms face up under the soles of your feet, fingertips towards your heels. Inhale, draw your chest through your upper arms and lengthen your side waists. Exhale, hinge forward as you hollow your belly, drop your skull, and loosen your neck. Remember, you could bend your knees any degree here to really feel freedom throughout your spine. A few breaths in this forward fold. You might like to shake and nod your head or flutter your lips a few times. That can feel releasing for your jaw if there's any tension in your face. And as you're flaring your elbows apart, let your shoulders float up away from your neck. Let's take three more breaths here. Slipping your palms out from underneath. Parangushtasana, another forward fold. So we're doing quite a bit of digestive promoting here, digestive flow, these compression postures. So use your index and middle fingers to clasp your big toes. You can use your thumbs to press into the ground. Inhale, draw your chest forward, elongate your spine, keep that length. You could bend your knees any amount. And then exhale, fold, bending your elbows apart to pull yourself in. Let the shoulders rise as the crown of your head drops. Three more breaths. Unclasp your big toes. Walk your hands forward into plank pose, top of a push-up. Bring your feet together to touch. Firm your inner heels back, draw your sternum forward, wrap your triceps towards your rear wall, broadening your shoulder blades across your back ribs. Kick your heels to the left to stack your feet for side plank. Option two, step your right foot in front of you like a kickstand for added support. As you raise your right arm to the sky, feel the essence of rooting into the earth to rebound a lift up, especially through your left side waist, left hip. Keep pressing your shoulder blades down your back for three more breaths. You could hover your right foot off the left if your feet are stacked, feet are both flexed. Front ribs hugging in, tailbone lengthening towards inner left heel. Take one more breath here in Vashisthasana. Circle your right arm overhead to plank. Lower your knees, spin your fingertips to turn towards the outer sides of your mat or towards your knees. Inhale into cow pose, draw your chest forward and up. Exhale to cat pose, round as you contract your belly. Last one, inhale, lifting your chest forward and up. Exhale, round, feel your shoulder blades spread apart. Keep a tinge of that protraction of your shoulder blades. Spin your index fingers forward, return to full plank, legs straight, feet together. Press your inner heels back, lift your navel towards your spine. You could try Uddiyana Bandha and Mula Bandha here if you like. Crown of the head forward, broaden the shoulder blades away from the neck. Kick your heels to the right, roll onto the outside edge of your right foot. Option to step the left foot in front of you like a kickstand. Raise your left arm towards the sky. Can you feel that tiger paw action in your right palm? So suction cup fingertips, a lift of energy through the center of the palms. It's that same essence of rooting to rise up, rooting through the outer edge of your right foot, lifting your right hip, right side waist. Shoulder blades down your back. Last three breaths. Option to hover your left foot over your right foot if you're stacking your feet. Front ribs hugging your back body. your tailbone lengthening towards your inner right heel. See if you could lift your right hip a little higher. Last breath in. Circle your left arm overhead. Come back to plank pose for a full vinyasa, or take your own rounds of cat-cow, maybe this time flipping your palms to face up to stretch your outer wrists again. Inhaling. Exhaling. Re-lengthen and rebalance your breath. All right, let's lean back onto your shins for a moment for a brief hero's pose, Virasana, to give your quadriceps, fronts of your thighs, a bit of lengthening. Now, you could sit on your shins if that works for you. If it doesn't work and the knees are sensitive to that, you can make a stool as high as you need. The higher, the less you're bending your knees. If you're able to sit on your shins, you might explore rolling your calves gently aside so that you could sit on the floor, adding more sensation to this pose. Make sure that in any case, your toes are all pointing back. Fan them out and press your pinky toenails onto the floor. Knees no wider apart than hips distance. Now, if you can to any degree, start to lean back. Imagine drawing your tailbone forward towards the space between your knees. It's a similar action to lifting your frontal hip bones towards your lowest front ribs, and that's to prevent hyper-arching your lower back. You may be able to lower your forearms behind you or use pillows under your back or lie all the way down. We're just here for 5 more deep breaths. Inhale deeply. Exhale 5. Inhale. Exhale 4. Inhale. Exhale 3. Inhale. Exhale 2. Last breath. Stay in the pose as you breathe out. Then gradually begin to lift your torso upright if you are lying back. Come on to hands and knees and tuck your right toes behind you as you straighten your right leg. Just releasing into the back of the knee. You might gently rock forward and back. You might even feel a calf stretch here. And then switch legs, straighten your left leg, tuck the toes, perhaps a little rocking forward and back. Listen to your ujjayi pranayama, that gentle whisper as you're breathing through the nose evenly. We're going to move into camel pose, 2 rounds. So if you have a yoga block, please use the skinniest width to hug in between your thighs. Come to stand on your knees, tuck your toes behind you, and bring your hands to your lower back with your fingertips pointing down. Bend your elbows closer together and feel your collarbones broaden. Draw your tailbone downward as your frontal hip bones slightly lift, toning your belly. Lift your back ribs, focus on lengthening your lower back and contracting the area just beneath your scapula, just beneath your shoulder blades mostly. Take a deep breath in, puff up your chest, and roll your shoulder heads back and down, exhaling. Give yourself about 5 to 7 breaths in this posture before you inhale to come up with the help of your hands and your lower back. Now, as you keep your pelvis right above your knees, if one or both heels are reachable with your hands, you can catch hold of them, holding them like baseballs. But make sure your hips stay forward to stack right above your knees here. heart center is lifting, expanding. Using this physical posture as well to help increase your capacity for inhalations. When you decide to come out of Ustrasana, camel pose, then just take a moment to sit back in Virasana, maybe using a block between your ankles, maybe resting your hands at your heart center, middle of your chest. And just breathing naturally for 3 cycles. Last round, when you're ready, at your own pace. Block between your thighs, toes tucked, or go a little further, flattening the tops of your feet on the floor. Take it on your own, coiling your chest up, keeping your hips forward, lengthening your tailbone down towards between your knees. 5 to 7 deep breaths, camel pose. And at your own pace, have a seat comfortably when you're finished. And just breathe naturally for a moment to observe the effects of that. If you'd like to use a strap for hand to knee pose, feel free to grab your strap and loop it around the ball of your left foot. Extend your left leg forward. Bring the sole of your right foot against your inner left thigh. Hold the strap in your right hand as you place your left hand on the floor beside your left outer hip. And as you root down through your sitting bones, breathe in to lengthen your spine, relax your shoulders. Exhale, rotate your rib cage to face your left wall slightly. And then extend the middle of your chest, your sternum forward to fold diagonally towards the upper left corner of your room. Pause as you breathe in and reground your 2 sitting bones, especially the right, while lengthening your spine forward. If available, fold even more as you breathe out for 3 more breaths. Parita, Janu Shirshasana. Revolved, head to knee pose. Keeping your belly firm, your back seeming flat. Inhale, slowly rise up. You have a strap, let's switch it over to your right foot. Extend your right leg forward. Bring the sole of your left foot to hug your inner right thigh. Hold the strap in your left hand, right hand outside right hip. Flex your right foot, sit up tall as you breathe in. Spiral your chest to face your right wall slightly and fold towards the upper right corner of your room as you breathe out. Pause, re-anchor your left sitting bone and elongate your spine. Exhale, fold a little more if possible. 3 more breaths. Again, maintaining the feeling of a flat back. Inhale, slowly rise up. So as we set up for Shavasana, I invite you to choose a posture that can help elevate your legs higher than your heart as you're lying on your back. If you have a wall, you can come into Viparita Karani, which is legs up the wall pose, glutes on the floor or lower back on a block, legs completely resting against the wall. Otherwise, you can make a little couch, stack some pillows and blocks to rest the medius portion of your calves on as you come to lie down. You might like to place a weighted blanket or another pillow to rest on your pelvis and belly, as that can feel soothing and grounding to help relax. So take your time to really offer your body the support it may need to rest comfortably in stillness. We've built quite a bit of fire, and our meditation is going to be a series of pranayama practices. And once you've found that corpse pose, closing your eyes, take one last deep inhalation. Imagine filling up all ends of your body from head to toe. Holding the breath in, you might sip in a little more, making any sound that feels releasing for you. Open your mouth when you're ready, let it go, and release control of your breath for these next few minutes of Shavasana. Slowly breathing in and open your mouth as you exhale. Let your fingers and toes gently move, bringing movement into your hands and feet. and gentle movement into your arms and legs, perhaps your head. Ease into a feel-good stretch for you, perhaps keeping your eyes closed. Gather your knees together into your chest, hugging them in. Just pause here for a few breaths. Feel the warmth and nurturing of your own embrace. And as you're ready, turn over to your right side, pressing the ground as you slowly rise. Sitting on your mat, a blanket or prop, feel what you're sitting on and anchor into that stability, that support. As you feel your groundedness lift through the center of your spine, feel the spaciousness, expansiveness throughout the rest of your body, welcoming life force to flow through the vehicle of your breath. Our guided meditation is a series of pranayama practices, as we know that pranayama itself can be a form of meditation. As Eckhart Tolle mentioned in the beginning, it helps to create a single focus in the mind, or excuse me, as Patabi Joyce mentioned. So we're going to begin with Durga pranayama, three-part breathing. We'll take a few cycles of that, and we'll transition into Kapalabhati pranayama, stoking fire within. It's called breath of fire as well, for 1 minute. I'll set the timer for that. And then we'll move into the use of the three energy locks, the bandhas, all three at once, Mula Bandha, Uddiyana Bandha, and Jalandhara Bandha at the end of breath of fire. And then we'll practice Nadi Shodhana, alternate nostril breathing. And then in the time remaining, we'll sit to observe the effects of our variety of breath practices. So let's begin placing left hand on the chest, right hand on the lower belly, imagining your torso as though it were a jar from your pelvic floor to your throat to your neck. And there are three parts to that jar: the lower portion at your lower belly, lower back, the mid portion at your side ribs, mid back, and the upper portion at your chest and shoulders. We'll breathe in to the lower belly portion. We'll hold the breath. Then we'll breathe into the side ribs. We'll hold. And then we'll breathe into the upper portion, holding in. And we'll empty the breath completely. So the inhale is through the nose, and the exhale is through the nose. Let's take a breath to clear out. Inhale deeply. Clear it out. Pause. Let's begin. Inhale into the lower belly. Pause. Inhale into your side ribs. Pause. Inhale into your chest. Hold your breath. Exhale through your nose completely. Again, inhale into your belly, lower belly. Pause. Inhale into your side ribs. Pause. Inhale into your chest. Hold it in. Through your nose, let it all go. This time, hold the breath at the bottom. Again, into your lower belly, inhale. Pause, side ribs, inhale. Pause, chest, inhale. Hold. Exhale slowly. Hold at the bottom. Last round of Durga Pranayama. Into the lower belly, inhale. Pause, into the side ribs, inhale. Pause, into your chest, inhale. Hold it in, relax your body, sit tall. Slowly empty your breath. Hold it out. And relax. So Kapalabhati breathing, mouth is closed. You can place your hands in your belly if you like. And it's a percussive exhale where the belly bounces in towards the spine. And there's a rhythm to it like this. So mouth is closed, passive inhale, active exhale bounces belly to spine. I'm gonna set the timer for 1 minute. Ready? Begin. Shoulders and face stay relaxed, spine is tall. Last 13 seconds. Take a deep breath in. Hold the breath in. Engage Mula Bandha, lift the pelvic floor. Engage Uddiyana Bandha, lower belly in and up. Tuck chin to chest, Jalandhara Bandha. Spine stays long. Hold the breath for as long as is comfortable for you. And whenever you're ready, let it go, relax. Moving into Nadi Shodhana, alternate nostril breathing. Resting your left hand on your lap, you might choose a mudra like Bliss Body Mudra, all fingers touch except pinky finger. Or for focusing, thumb and index finger to touch. Or for energy vitality, bring the index and middle finger to stick out and the thumb closes the ring and pinky finger. Resting left hand on your lap, bring your right thumb, pinky and ring finger to stick up. Sitting up tall, maybe close your eyes, relax your shoulders. Empty this breath to begin. Hold your breath out. Right thumb covers right nostril. Inhale slowly through your left. Hold the breath in. Last two fingers cover left nostril. Exhale gently and slowly through your right. Hold your breath out. Inhale through right. Hold it in. Cover right with thumb. Exhale through left. Hold it out. Inhale left. Hold it in. Cover left. Gently exhale through right. Hold it out. Inhale through right. Hold it in. Cover right. Exhale through left. Hold it out. Release both hands, perhaps both taking the mudra of your choice. Sitting here for the last 2 minutes to observe the effects of your pranayama practice. Thank you. you're ready to close practice. Let your palms come together at your heart, bowing in. You have these wonderful, time-tested tools for vitality, for calming your mind, calming your nervous system, for stoking your digestive fire, and helping inner flow. I hope that you find ways to integrate them into your daily life. Let's close with one chant of Om. Take a deep breath. The light in me bows to the light in you. Namaste.